Hello everyone. Welcome to Learnaholic India. Today we are going to learn FTP, File Transfer Protocol, which is application layer protocol from computer network. The topics that we are going to learn in today's session are: What is FTP? Objectives of FTP. Why FTP? Working of FTP. FTP clients. Advantages of FTP. Disadvantages of FTP. So without wasting time, let's start with today's session. First of all, the question arises, what is FTP? FTP stands for File Transfer Protocol. FTP is a standard internet protocol provided by TCP/IP used for transmitting the files from one host to another. It is mainly used for transferring the web page files from their creator to the computer that acts as a server for other computers on the internet. It is also used for downloading the files to computer from other servers. Next topic is objectives of FTP. The objectives of FTP are: to promote sharing of files that are computer programs and/or data. To encourage indirect or implicit via programs use of remote computers. To shield a user from variations in file storage systems among hosts. To transfer data reliably and efficiently. Next topic is why FTP? Or one can ask, what is the need of FTP? Although transferring files from one system to another is very simple and straightforward, but sometimes it can cause problems. For example, two systems may have different file conventions. Two systems may have different ways to represent text and data. Two systems may have different directory structures. FTP protocol overcomes these problems by establishing two connections between hosts. One connection is used for data transfer, and another connection is used for the control connection. Now let's see working of FTP. The figure shows the basic model of the FTP. The FTP client has three components: the user interface, control process, and data transfer process. The server has two components: the server control process and the server data transfer process. When you want to copy files between two computers that are on the same local network, often you can simply share a drive or folder, and copy the files the same way you would copy files from one place to another on your own PC. What if you want to copy files from one computer to another that is halfway around the world? You would probably use your internet connection. However, for security reasons, it is very uncommon to share folders over the internet. File transfers over the internet use special techniques, of which one of the oldest and most widely used is FTP. FTP, short for File Transfer Protocol, can transfer files between any computers that have an internet connection, and also works between computers using totally different operating systems. Transferring files from a client computer to a server computer is called uploading, and transferring from a server to a client is called downloading. Next point is, what are FTP connections? There are two types of connections in FTP. First is control connection. The control connection uses very simple rules for communication. Through control connection, we can transfer a line of command or line of response at a time. The control connection is made between the control processes. The control connection remains connected during the entire interactive FTP session. Second is data connection. The data connection uses very complex rules, as data types may vary. The data connection is made between data transfer processes. The data connection opens when a command comes for transferring the files and closes when the file is transferred. Next points is FTP clients. FTP client is a program that implements a file transfer protocol which allows you to transfer files between two hosts on the internet. It allows a user to connect to a remote host and upload or download the files. It has a set of commands that we can use to connect to a host, transfer the files between you and your host, and close the connection. The FTP program is also available as a built-in component in a web browser. This GUI-based FTP client makes the file transfer very easy and also does not require to remember the FTP commands. Now let's see some advantages of FTP. First advantage is speed. One of the biggest advantages of FTP is speed. The FTP is one of the fastest way to transfer the files from one computer to another computer. Next is efficiency. It is more efficient as we do not need to complete all the operations to get the entire file. Next is security. To access the FTP server, we need to log in with the username and password. Therefore, we can say that FTP is more secure. Next is back and forth movement. FTP allows us to transfer the files back and forth. Suppose you are a manager of the company, you send some information to all the employees, and they all send information back on the same server. There are disadvantages of FTP also, let's see one by one. The standard requirement of the industry is that all the FTP transmissions should be encrypted. However, not all the FTP providers are equal and not all the providers offer encryption. So, we will have to look out for the FTP providers that provides encryption. FTP serves two operations, that is, to send and receive large files on a network. However, the size limit of the file is 2 GB that can be sent. It also doesn't allow you to run simultaneous transfers to multiple receivers. Next is passwords and file contents are sent in clear text that allows unwanted eavesdropping. So, it is quite possible that attackers can carry out the brute force attack by trying to guess the FTP password. It is not compatible with every system. Thank you for watching today's session. If you are new to this channel, then subscribe to Learnaholic India and don't forget to click on the bell icon for the latest video updates. You can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. Social media links are given in the description below. If you like today's video, then like it, share with your friends. If you have any query, then please comment below. That's it for today. Stay tuned for next video. Thank you.